What do you think?
It oozes charm.
Yeah, this is great. Just the kind of house we like.
Is it?
It is.
You said that about the last one. Is this any different?
I think it's very similar.
Yeah, nice character, period house.
Interestingly, this was two cottages.
Oh.
And it's now joined together as one.
Okay.
And it's a very typical sort of Surrey style with its two gables.
Yeah.
And the lovely wooden turned work above the porch.
Oh, that's good.
Actually, the owner here works in the city, and it takes him exactly an hour and a half from door to door to his desk. So can you imagine this being your home?
Certainly the house from the outside, yes.
Let's go in.
Okay.
If they lived in this delightful character property, Matt would have a slightly longer commute than he would like to his office, of an hour and 40 minutes. But their dream setting is found in the south of the county, which is further from the city. Nevertheless, things have started well, and long may that continue.
Come on in. Straight into the sitting room.
Okay.
You can see this is where the two houses were knocked together.
Well, right.
So actually that side used to be the kitchen of the one house, and then this is been knocked together as one big, long sitting room.
Oh, this is
huge.
We thought this is a bit more what you had in mind in terms of the big kitchen dining space.
Yes.
Absolutely. No, it's much bigger. Yeah, it looks very nice.
And I like the wood countertops and the sort of old school feel. I like the butler sink.
Oh,
that's where
good.
I spend a lot of my time.
All right, okay, very good. But this is, I think, a really lovely space, a big sort of family breakfast room. And it's heated, which is quite nice for a conservatory. So.
That is nice. Yeah,
I'm getting a slightly sort of dampened vibe.
I don't know if it's too narrow. I don't know if it's because the rooms are very rectangular that feeling is sort of turning me off. But I think this room is very appealing.
Yeah, so this was the second half of the house.
Okay.
And now this is the dining room.
It's a very elegant room.
And then through there, there's what they call the snug, which was the sitting room of the original house.
Moving upstairs, there are two bathrooms, a single bedroom, and four bright doubles of roughly the same size. We've come to one at the front of the house.
It's a little small. I don't really feel like a master bedroom, but it's very quaint and it's very charming and it does have high ceilings.
It is a bit small though, that's for sure.
Is the upstairs growing on you?
I like the upstairs better. I think maybe it's the square feel to the rooms that I like and the higher ceilings.
It's clear Matt and Catherine are looking for something unique in their country home. And although they were excited by this house's exterior, the inside doesn't seem to match up for them. But outside, once again, I'm hoping the garden and the views might make them change their mind.
It's equally pretty from the back as it is from the front.
And the garden, they haven't really done much. You could do all sorts here. There's another little plot down here. It used to be the veggie patch. But actually, right in the corner, you get a fantastic view, and you can see Leith Tower, which is, as I know, the highest point in the southeast.
Oh, you're a wealth of information, Alistair.
I am.
Look at that.
It's exciting.
Very exciting.
Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce you to the mystery house.
Wow. This is a lovely cottage.
Cottage.
House. But it has a charm. It has a charm, is what I meant.
So we've moved you even further south, across the border into West Sussex. Further away from London, but
the commute
is shorter.
Wow. Is it?
Because Littlehaven is a village. It's a 3-minute drive. And the trains go every half hour straight into London Bridge.
You are.
Actually, this is the best commute.
Alistair, you're a genius. Well done.
That's just the commute. We haven't even started on the house, which is, I think, a bit of a masterpiece. It was a small farmhouse cottage, and the present owner has completely transformed it.
I'm in trouble. I can feel it. I'm in trouble.
I'm excited to go inside.
Let's have a look.
Okay.
Catherine admitted to me that exterior character is a must, but doesn't have to follow through inside. So I'm sure she'll be impressed by this 4-bedroom extended cottage, which has been modernized throughout to an immaculate standard, making it a perfect blend of old meets new.
Actually, rather unusually, I'm going to ask you to stop in the hall.
Okay.
Because this is quite an architectural feature.
Well, this is a surprising contrast to the outside of the house.
Yeah, but you can see this is a taste of what's to come because the owner has...
grand.
Yeah, exactly, made something grand from what was quite a modest farmhouse by going right up to the very top of the attic in one space.
But it's open and it's airy and it's well done.
Yeah.
It looks very high quality.
This is nice. It's got the sitting area we were looking for, plenty of counter space, plenty of storage space, and you know, really nice finish.
Very nice finish. And the sliding doors that open right out into the garden.
Yeah.
Amazing. Amazing.
I'm definitely in trouble on this one.
It is gorgeous.
Why do you keep on saying you're in trouble?
Gorgeous. He's scared of himself. He doesn't want to like it.
Scared of your own desire. Let it go. Release the desire.
Off the kitchen is a utility room leading to a carport and a garage. Moving into the middle of the house is a sizable sitting room.
Wow.
Yeah, this is a wow room too.
This is a wow room. That's a very interesting wood burner.
Beautiful oak floors throughout, like real oak.
Yeah, that's a good size room.
And it flows very nicely into the kitchen, very comfortably.
Can you imagine yourself after a hard day in the city coming back?
Yeah, it would certainly be a nice place to come back to.
This is a lovely room too.
Mm. Oh, wow.
Yeah, this is nice. Great dining area.
Yeah. Well, what a lovely formal place if you had some friends around.
It's perfect.
As we move upstairs, there's a clever use of space with a mezzanine study above the landing. There's a family bathroom, three double bedrooms, one with an ensuite and one with its own mezzanine level in the eaves, and the master with views over the garden and surrounding fields.
Beautiful. With a balcony off of it?
With a balcony, yeah.
And the doors.
Yeah. And again, you got
can woo you from the garden.
You can would do you Juliet. Serenade me? Yes.
But again, you can concertina those doors open so you could sit here in the evening because you get the evening sun.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Gosh, I mean, this whole house is so immaculate. Mm. It is just incredible.
Is this what you were thinking about as a master?
Yes, this is exactly what I picture a master to be.
But Catherine ain't seen nothing yet.
I have to say, I've seen some en-suites.
There's more?
This is an en-suite. Bit of a walk-in wardrobe dressing room.
Oh, my God.
And welcome to the ensuite world.
You are kidding me.
I'm definitely in trouble.
Okay,
now.
This is too much. This is too much. We can't afford this. This is incredible. This is just.
This is a good.
This is a beautiful living
you
space.
Could live here.
I mean, I could. I could, Matt. I could.
Okay. Well, we can talk about that.
Okay. It's like my dream. You can have
no pressure here, right? No pressure.
Matt's face is like, oh God.
You can have the balcony off the master, and I can have the walk-in.
Isn't there a highway around here or something? Something help me out.
So we're getting thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Even from you.
Yeah, thumbs up.